Welcome to 2K Sports. We're ready to brighten the weekend with some Saturday night basketball. Welcome, everyone, courtside with two ex-NBA stars, Grant Hill and Brent Berry. I'm Brian Anderson. We've got Allie LaForce on the sidelines tonight as well. We've got the Boston Celtics facing the New York Knicks. And so off the tip, it is New York. Richardson with it, looking at the starting five for the Boston Celtics. Pass to DeBuscher. Shot clock at six. New York needs to get one up quick. The timer ticks. Russell with the rebound. Here's Havlicek. From deep. That's good.
This is how you begin a game. Set the tone right from the jump.
Take a nice deep breath. You score on that first possession. Gets the game started the right way.
Fires from the wing. And that's off the glass and in.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do. And right at the top is guard that guy.
Pass to Bird. And we're about a minute into the first. Here's Cowens. Solid as a rock from 20 feet out.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
Yeah, the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort. Got burned on that one.
Now here's Richardson. And the baseline jumper, no good.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Pass to Bird. Three-pointer. That shot off the mark. New York goes the other way with it. Outside Richardson. Poke loose. Stolen by Russell. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
And setting the tempo with an assertive move. Like, where was the defense on that play?
Yeah, APB sent out to try to find out where the defense is. Inexcusable.
Fantastic replay we just saw of the Mobile One drive.
Yeah, and in close games like this one, BA, you need toughness. Guys who will run to the fight and get after it.
Bird. He got a piece of it. Pass to Richardson. The three. That's tipped.
Yeah, not really much of a flow offensively yet. Only one of four from the field.
Good on the shot. Who's he? He's got six.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking and he knows it.
Yeah, right now I don't see any let up. Think he's going to just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal tonight.
Now a timeout called by New York.
And the other team is running all over them right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit chat with the team to settle down.
Making us move nightly. That was your Knicks City Dancer.
And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes play. Takes the three. Russell with the rebound.
One of five to start the game. They have to slow down and just play their brand of basketball.
Sends it home from three-point land.
3 points. Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Pass to Ewing. And out of bounds. Boston will have it.
That's just poor communication between those two. The passer has to make sure his teammate is established, and the teammate has to know the pass is coming. See, that's communication.
A remarkable defensive play. The replay showing once again the tenacity on that end.
And that kind of rejection early on energizes your squad. The coaching staff just loves this kind of hustle.
Here's Cowens. Here's Havlicek. No good on the triple.
Just terrible defense. I don't know how he missed that shot.
Garnett. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Personal foul.
And even first from where we're foul. Sitting, you could clearly tell it was a foul.
The first free throw is good. Well, the naming of the NBA's 75th anniversary team was a fun event last season. That sparked plenty of conversation, Brent.
Yeah, it was really interesting to see how it is the NBA settled on 75. So many memorable players throughout the decades. But I really enjoyed the event. I really enjoyed seeing all of those players once again getting together to be celebrated for all of their accomplishments and for building the foundation of what the NBA is today.
And this defense needs to turn the screws and ramp up the intensity. They're looking a little loose out there right now.
To the inside. Here's Ewing. And again, the Knicks missing. Boston on offense. They're on a 14-3 run. Here's Russell. No good off the glass.
Gotta appreciate the aggressive defense he brings.
Well, it's about the defensive end, and that's what guys feed off. He gives the effort down there at all times.
Yeah, that one's good.
Now that's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Here's Havlicek. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Outside Russell. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Here's Cowens. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a fair.
It's so close on the finish. I mean, it could have been a three-point opportunity.
And he makes a first.
Two shots.
So he gets them both.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
Pass to DeBuscher. Outside Richardson. 6 on the shot clock. There's the block.
Well, he's just really struggling right now with everything he's throwing up. Nothing really helping out in terms of his confidence. I mean, these ones aren't even close.
Now here's Richardson. Shoot from the baseline. He misses it. 0-for-5 and looking off his game right now.
Yeah, pretty safe to say that this is the kind of game that you just want to flush as soon as you get done with it.
And that one drops.
They've shown so much energy right from the start, particularly on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
Here's Ewing. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. It's good.
Good passing in the paint may be even more important to an offense than great passing on the perimeter. Those are areas where you got to be careful.
Drains the triple. 11 points in the game.
He's putting on a show this quarter, and the team's feeding off his energy.
Now a timeout called by New York.
Failing to find a rhythm offensively. Something that needs to change and change soon.
Yeah, they're like a four-day-old soda right now, just flat. They're missing shots left and right and just not playing their best.
Now Richardson. Two on one as they jump out on the break. Here's Havlicek. Again, the Celtics good for two more. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Celtics.
Yeah, they're just attacking on defense, getting those hands out and knocking the ball free. I really like their energy defensively.
Well, they've done a great job tonight of getting out in transition, so that focus on fast break add to your total in a hurry.
And yep, it's good.
And he knows he can make this shot. I mean, clearly there's no indecision for him from there.
There's something to be said about knowing yourself. It allows him to shoot and shoot comfortably, even with taller defenders out there.
Pass to Cowens. Here's Havlicek, down to 5 on the shot clock. And the Celtics have another three.
Oh, it's just raining threes for them early.
Here's Richardson. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. And there's
misses the rejection.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Here's Havlicek, and that one's long. Here's DeBuscher to the paint. Here's Garnett. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
And you have to love the focus. He gets hit, but converts it anyway.
So both teams making some changes here.
At the line, one shot.
Boston dictating the flow. Outside, Brown. Brunson against Jones. Pass to Cowens. Outside, Brown. And here's Jones. Over Brunson. Jones misses. And here's New York now. Shoots. No good off the back of the rim. Pass to Bird. Some room here for Jones. It's on target from the high post.
Their offense looking like a well-oiled machine.
So it's the Knicks now. It's an 18-point game. Brunson against Jones. Now here's Brunson. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Here's Bird. It's Brown on the wing. Another one falls for Boston.
This speaks to Brown's desire to become a focal point of this offense. He's such a confident shooter now.
And Brunson, here we go. Pass to Houston. Here's Brunson. Defended by Jones. Here's Houston. Ooh, that misses badly. Air ball. Here are the Celtics with the ball. Here's Tatum. And King pulls it down. Back to Brunson. To the left side wing. Here's King. Hounded by Tatum. Four on the clock. Here's King. No good. Now the Celtics take it the other way. Outside Tatum. Pass to Cowens. Here's Bird. The shot, no good. Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
And that one's good for Brunson.
Just owning the painted area. If it's working, no need to change.
They've done a great job of moving the ball tonight.
Yeah, BA, keeping everybody involved keeps everyone engaged.
And there's 1:38 left to play in the first. Again, the miss by the Celtics. So it's the Knicks now. They trail by 18, coming off that win against the Sixers.
Sometimes it's difficult to get good looks on the road, but they ran the offense brilliantly.
Well, it was probably a good feeling in that last game that the mid-range work, the long-range work, the inside game work, but the best feeling was the crowd leaving that building not in a good mood.
And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
Not getting old here, seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
105 left now in the first quarter. Outside, Brown. And here's Jones. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
First personal foul.
Jalen Brunson picks one up.
Sam Jones. At the line, two shots.
The first one falls. Jones hits them both. 51 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. To the right side. Pass to Marbury. Over Jones. And it's Marbury missing. Boston dictating the flow. Here's Brown. And Brown with the stuff!
Look at how Tatum surveys the whole floor. That's how he spots the wide open man.
Here's Marbury. There's 21 seconds left in the opening quarter. Five to shoot. Shot on the wing. Ooh, and an air ball on that one. Way off. To the middle. Here's Pierce. That falls. Nice feed that time from Tatum.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another.
And that's it for the first quarter in what has been a very lopsided game. Celtics out in front, opening up a huge gap. And we'll be back right after this.
Fans, your Knicks City Kings.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And guys, we've seen the Celtics really take control here.
Well, you have to credit their effort on the defensive end. It set the tone for this contest.
Yeah, defense has been infectious here as everybody stepping up aggressively on that end.
On the court for the Celtics, second quarter underway. Outside Russell. Pass to Havlicek. Six to shoot. Here's Pierce. Fires the three. The offensive rebound. Locked! Here's Reed. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Good. So it's Boston now, and keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
Thank you very much, Brian. Well, Jaylen Brown has been vocal when it comes to social justice. He said, quote, people need to step up and use their platform. Keep conversations alive and show people that you care. Where your influence is biggest, try to leverage it. Brian, he knows his stuff.
Stand up. Allie, thanks. To the wing, right side. Just five on the clock. Here's DeBuscher. Pulled the shot a little left. The bounce goes his way, though.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
Yeah, the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort got burned on that one.
And it's going to be out of bounds. Boston will have another go.
Substitution for your Knicks, Kevin Garnett, Michael Ray Richardson.
A minute and a half gone in the second quarter. Here's Pierce. Just four to shoot. Late clock. The Celtics got to hurry here. And it's Ewing with a rebound. And here are the Knicks. They haven't allowed any points in the second quarter. Here's Richardson. Second shot opportunity. Nice. Gets his second bucket. He's 2 for 4 now.
A stronger defensive presence would have saved them 2 points.
Didn't seem like anybody was really aware there to go and collect that rebound in the possession.
Russell, it's good on the putback. Russell's got his first 2 points of the night.
Now that takes a skillful touch.
Yeah, excellent control to just ease the ball back up and in. Here's Garnett. The Knicks rebound. Over to the wing. Pass to DeBuscher. Here's the three. It's rebounded by Pierce. Here's to Buescher. Out to the right wing. Outside Richardson. Pass to Buescher. And here's Richardson. Launches it. Here's Garnett. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
Everyone in the building saw the obvious contact.
Kevin Garnett at the line. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Both shots good from the strike.
Makes it pretty tough on the defense. Who are you going to pick to send to the free throw line? And he's hitting the free throws right now. Form looks good.
Pass to Havlicek. Lets it go from deep. Drills it from deep. 10 points for him.
Sweet to be a difference maker in the game, and he's been a great option for them on these possessions.
Here's to Buescher. Here's Ewing. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. From 8 feet away, got a hand on it. Here's Havlicek. He's got 10. Pass to Russell. The three is up. And the Celtics, another three.
Their defense has to do a better job of smothering those shooters.
Richardson with it. Out to the wing. Russell with the rebound. Russell's got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
Well, his poor shooting is a big reason that they're staring at this deficit right now. He needs to get on track if they're going to find a way to win.
Havlicek's shot is off. Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Here's Garnett. And he converts the layup.
That's been the story of their offense so far. Getting a number of looks from point-blank range.
Going all in, that was the 2K drive. Well worth a second look.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
The floater and the layup is good.
The floater can be a tricky shot, but that's the right choice.
Outside Richardson. No luck on that one. And the Celtics going the other way now.
Yeah, this has been a night where you could look at his shooting and his performance, and it's affected the team. That's the bottom line. If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started. Now, catching the lead pass at full speed, terrific anticipation, and the delivery on time, on target.
Inside. And that's his fourth bucket in 9 attempts.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Setting up in the half court where they've been somewhat ineffective.
And that's in part because this defense has been so solid.
First personal foul. First team foul. Checking in for the Celtics, Dave Cowens.
On defense, the Knicks. It's an 18-point game. Outside Richardson. Knocked away. Pass to Ewing. Clock at 6. Here's to Buescher.
Well, that's a shot they want just about on every possession, if they can get it. He doesn't make them all, but still very much a high percentage look.
This one for 3. Bird, that's good. 17 points in the game.
And just executing at a high level. I mean, taking what the defense allows and putting in the work.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
32.
It's his second foul, but not the end of the world. One more before halftime, though. That would change some things.
Second team foul. Checking in for the Celtics, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown.
Here's Cowan Jones.
Outside, Brown. Shot clock at 6. Shoots from 14. The shot won't fall. New York with the ball, trailing by 19. And the shot by DeBuscher, no good.
Probably should have scored there. He usually does.
Shot from 16, and it's Ewing with a rebound. Oh, swiped away. Pass to Brown. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
And sly move by Brown to ensure the foul. He won't pass up on a chance to draw one off you.
And both free throws good for Brown. Here's Houston, looking for his first basket still in this one. Right wing, Brown with the steal. Here they come with numbers in transition. Tatum from long range, and the three-pointer goes.
There's no lack of confidence in Tatum when it comes to his three-point shot. He's looking to do damage from long range on every possession.
Defended by Jones. Pass to King. Six on the shot clock. Here's Randle, and it's Randle with the jam.
So active and understanding more and more with his experience where to be to get offensive rebounds from Julius Randle.
They're enjoying a sizable lead.
And what I like, BA, they haven't stopped pressing the issue.
Here's Cowens. Pass to Jones. Here's Russell. And then Russell with the dunk.
And this is something he does all too well. Great position for the putback there.
And I like how he doesn't think twice about passing it out. Just going right for the slam.
Oh, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
Here's King. That one a tad offline, but it drops in for him.
Mid-range, plenty of room for that release. He's going to take those all day long.
Pass to Tatum. Up top, Brown. The Knicks pull it in. Here's Houston. Cowens grabs the board. And so it's Boston with it. Here's Tatum. Uses the glass on the layup. Tatum's got 5 now.
With the skills of a guard, Tatum has the size of a power forward. It makes him so tough to stop inside.
Chalk up 2 there.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Outside Jones. Pass to Brown. Step back and fire. Again, the Celtics good for 2 more.
A superb mid-range shooter. All Brown needs is some separation, and he's ready to pull up.
Tries it from 16. No good on the shot. And Boston going the other way now. We've got 1:28 left in the first half. Tatum finds Russell. Oh, he got him with a pump fake, but he couldn't finish. Russell's gone 2 of 5 from the field here. Defended by Jones. Down low. And he dunks it. What a pass to set him up.
He put some rage into that one, BA.
You're telling me. 1:03 left in the first half of this one. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
And things are always changing throughout a game. Teams have to adjust on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
teams deciding to change it up.
Once again, for your Knicks City Kids.
...59 seconds left to play in the half. Boston, no good that time either.
Is it getting cold in here? This is a tough one. Crucial that he starts to work a little harder for a higher percentage shot.
Here's Ewing. That one, no good. And Boston going the other way now. There's Tatum with the three. Randle pulls down the board.
And we haven't seen them pound the ball inside and draw as much contact this quarter.
Pass to Ewing. 26 seconds left in the first half of this game. And the shot by DeBuscher, no good. Now here's Tatum. Three-pointer. And he knocks it down. He's 3 of 5 now from the floor.
Yeah, this story in the second quarter, much different than the one in the first. We're finally seeing some aggression.
On the wing, Richardson, hounded by Tatum. Richardson, no good. And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. It's the Celtics just dominating this one. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Things were going Boston's way from the beginning. Their energy offensively and defensive mindset triggered a 14-3 onslaught to start this game. They delivered a real beatdown in the first quarter, ending with a whopping lead. Then in quarter number two, they actually increased their intensity to pull further out in front, finishing with a double-digit advantage at the half. Kenny, what's your take on Boston so far?
They played smart, they took their time and limited mistakes. When you value each possession, you eventually get the shot. But when you lose the ball, you have no control over the destiny.
And Shaq, what are your thoughts on New York?
Well, with the way they struggled to defend the three-point line, it started to look like warm-up drills. They cannot be afraid to bring more defenders out high. They got to make life tougher on those outside shooters.
And that's a wrap for our halftime show. The third quarter just about to get started.
Here they are, fans. Put your
hands. And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. Boston on offense. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 25. Pass to Bird. Now Russell. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Tatum. Not going to go that time. New York goes the other way with it. And for the Celtics. And he drops it in from the low post. 10 points for him.
A great move. I mean, the defense has no response.
Well, just ripping through right there as he finds the open spot and gets right through there. High basketball IQ play.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Here's DeBuscher. Hits a three-pointer.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around. Keep it moving. Try to get an assist on every bucket.
To the inside. Russell. And then Russell with the dunk.
What elevation. He's a smaller but still determined big man. And he likes mixing it up with his impressive vert.
Now here's Richardson. Defense right on him. And play stops. A whistle there on what looks like an illegal screen.
You're not going to fool the officials too often on an illegal screen.
Yeah, everybody saw that one. That was pretty blatant there.
And a second look at that rejection, taking no prisoners on defense there.
Oh, now that was a block. Some much-needed energy there to jumpstart them back into this game.
The Celtics making a switch here. And so it's Boston with it. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. Here's Russell, and then Russell with the dunk.
There's just no reason to give him inside position.
Yeah, when he's this close to the basket, it's a wrap.
Beyond the arc. Boston with a rebound. Inside, here's Havlicek, and that one is hammered home.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
That one's true. He's now 9 of 10.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Yeah, the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
Michael Ray Richardson, third personal foul. First team foul.
Guarded by Richardson from outside the arc.
Even if you're not shooting it, you like to see the effort level, and his tonight has been high.
Pass to Ewing. And he gets it to go.
Yeah, they've only missed one out of their first five shots here in the second half, guys. Their offense really moving well, ball snapping, and the shooting looks to be in great rhythm.
Here's Bird. Here's Cowens. No good with the triple. Right around 3 minutes into this second half, that one falls. 12 points for him.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
Pass to Havlicek. Guarded by Richardson. Here's Cowens. It's deflected. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
John Havlicek, first personal foul, first team foul. Richie Guerin at the line. One shot.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Pass to Havlicek. Here's the floater. And he takes it up and lays it in. And the Celtics lead by 19.
When a player gets a feel for that floater, it can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard them and where your point of commitment is.
Now here's Richardson. The D's right on him. Here's Garnett. Oh, he is cooking right now. 10 for 11 from the field.
Good things come to those who hustle. He creates the second chance opportunity.
Pass to Havlicek. Guarded by Richardson. Goes up at the stripe. That shot is off. And New York the other way now. To the paint. Getting it to fall there. He's 8 of 15 in the game.
Celtics lead 73-58.
Here's Havlicek. The 11-footer. Off the left rim and out. And here are the Knicks now. 15-point game. Knocks it loose. Pass to Garnett. Now Richardson, guarded by Russell. Six to shoot. Looking to end this cold spell. And the layup is good by Richardson. Richardson's got his second bucket of the night.
It would take some very special defense to stop him once he gets that close to the bucket. And they weren't special that time.
And Boston calls time here.
Oh, my. Their coach does not look happy. And I can guess why. Their interior defense has been struggling.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring. And if you can get to a high-efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
And your Knicks City kid makes some noise.
A chance here to catch up with Allie from the sideline.
Well, guys, the NBA markets itself behind star players, but Commissioner Adam Silver understands what makes the game tick. He said, quote, "This is a team sport. In order to truly win championships and compete at the highest level, all the players have to come together."
So true, Allie. Thank you.
Well done on the glass. Gets himself in position where he can use his size.
Here's Garnett. Off target with the three. With the teardrop. And it's good on the lay-in.
Assist from
14 points for him.
I just think that's trouble. You're gonna let that guy shoot layups. You're asking for it.
Richardson, that's good.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
Celtics lead 75-62.
Pass to Havlicek. Here's Bird. Guarded by Richardson. Clock at 6. Here's Havlicek. 12 points for him. It's tipped. And here we go. The Knicks in transition. Tipped. It's an even 3-on-3 break. Pass to Cousy from behind the arc.
Celtics foul. Ball Pierce. Second personal foul.
The Celtics making a switch here.
Checking in for the Celtics, Kevin McHale.
And here's New York now. They're on a 17-4 run. Outside Richardson. Here's DeBuscher. 5 points in the game. Here's Ewing. And he lays it up and in.
There's some easy offense there. Keep finding looks in that area, and their shooting percentages tonight are going to be off the charts.
Out to the right wing. Pass to Cousy. Here's Bird. Here's Havlicek. Boston again missing.
Something's off about him this quarter.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Here's DeBuscher. Puts one up from 19. He hits the back iron and sinks it. He has 7.
They finally found their shooting touch after a rough first half.
66.
And Boston calls time here. And the players take this opportunity to get some Gatorade. Getting some fluids in you is so important during these timeouts. Get fresh, keep those batteries charged.
Yeah, without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a ball game. And that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have to be hydrated.
Let's hear it for your Knicks City Dancer.
Pass to Havlicek. Here's Pierce. Here's Havlicek. 5 on the clock. Here's Bird. Another miss. Boy, they're in a funk right now. New York trailing. Here's Reed. Here's Houston. Again, the Knicks. Good for 2 more.
They're making smart adjustments, setting guys up for success.
The possession's just way more efficient, I think, here tonight. Taking smarter, better shots, moving the ball around. That's helped them to get back in the ballgame.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the 3-point line.
King gets the bucket.
The execution has been better lately. Do they have enough energy to pull it off?
Well, they've shown both effort and will to get back into this one, but can they finish this one off? Can't let up now.
Pass to Cousy, up and over Richardson, and it's Ewing with a rebound. Here's King. Ooh, a two-handed
power slam.
They're doing the job on both ends, getting stops and attacking offensively.
Yeah, coaching staff probably loves this, just grinding out defensive possessions, which is helping them get back into their offensive flow.
And Boston calls time here.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tide?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
Tatum, he's checked in for Boston.
Jason Tatum.
Pass to Bird. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming this way.
Second team foul. Larry Bird at the line. Two shots.
And he drops a first. And he makes both free throws. Now Richardson. He's got six. Pass to King. Here's Ewing. Shot clock at six. The fader. Another one falls for New York.
Yeah, these teams are playing with incredible energy.
At least in the second half they have been. The first half wasn't played anywhere near this intense.
Here's Havlicek. He's got 12. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
You wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the glass.
Now here's Richardson. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And now just a one-point Celtic lead. And it's a Celtics ball to the middle. Here's Bird. And he drains it, making him 7 for 15 for the day.
Keeping pace here. That's an excellent move inside.
Outside Richardson. There's a minute 17 left in the third quarter here. It's New York scoring again.
The defense had him confused early on, but he's responded in the second half with some assertive play.
Pass to Havlicek. There's Tatum with the three. The Knicks with the rebound. This lead is up for grabs.
Yeah, each possession has an importance.
They now take the lead. Give him eight.
They fought so hard to get themselves in a position to win this game.
Well, there's an ebb and a flow. They had a hard time earlier, but now, flow.
Pass to Havlicek, and here's Tatum. Here's Havlicek. Here's Bird. And Reed pulls it down. 23 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Ewing, hounded by Tatum. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a three-second call.
Substitution on the court.
Boston trailing. Pass to Cousy from deep. He can't get that one to fall. We're at the end of the third quarter, and we've still got a close one. Knicks out in front, up one. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And I'll tell you what, this was a no-brainer tonight. Take a look at the precision on this feed. Couldn't place it any better.
Well, there's a way to break down the defense with the handle, but you can do it with the pass. Prime example of that right there.
No holding back.
Man, I know I speak for all of us when I say I can't wait to see what kind of finish awaits us here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Sprewell. Four on the clock. For three. Boston with a rebound. Russell's got rebound number 15 here tonight. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Knocked loose. To the paint. The layup off target. The
defense is tough as it comes right there. He's a hard man to deny when he gets the ball to the rim.
Releases. And off the left side of the rim, it swirls in for him. And the Celtics lead by one.
And just great intensity down the stretch. I mean, he really wants to rock with the game on the line.
Now take a look at him. Locked in right now in this moment. Wants the ball in his hands and feels real comfortable with the shot he's taking.
Six of their last 10 points have come from that mid-range area. 81.
Outside Tatum. Pass to Havlicek. Outside Tatum. Six on the shot clock. Here's Cowens. The shot misses. New York goes the other way with it. Down low. Here's Randle. Buries it down low. And now a three-point Knick lead.
Setting each other up beautifully. I love it. Eight of their last 10 points coming off assist.
Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. To the wing, right side. And he sinks the 11-footer.
Who's he?
Here's Sprewell. Pass to DeBuscher. Out to the right wing. Baseline jumper. Again, the Knicks. Good for two more.
They're playing great team basketball. It's good movement and sharp, crisp passing. 83.
Outside Tatum. Here's Cowens. Checked by Randle. Shot clock at five. Cowens, no good. The Knicks with the lead. Pass to Sprewell. There's the three. That one doesn't drop. Outside Tatum. It's rebounded by New York. Randle's got four rebounds in the game. Tatum's gotten three of his eight shots to go. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone by in the fourth. Here's Sprewell. Rebounded by the Celtics.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them.
Pass to Tatum. To tie it up. The putback. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
He's caught fire here in the second half. Better late than never.
Inside. And it's Randle with the jam.
Randle with massive improvement over last year. He can beat you in so many ways that he has confidence in now. What a flush.
Tatum finds Russell. Here's Havlicek. Here's Cowens. Lays it up and banks it in.
Zero rim protection. Unforgivable in a tight ball game like this.
Well, I hope there's one player on that team out there that has interest in winning this game. Right now, it doesn't look to be one.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Whoa, a drive like that is the kind of play that can shift the entire outcome of a close game like this one.
And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
first personal foul.
And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Celtics.
You have to be a fan of the energy they played with on the defensive end. Active hands and feet, and it's come up big a few times for them.
Well, if we add another thing to it, it's about the urgency they've played with. I mean, you look at the eyes of these guys. They're focused, wanting to get up-tempo, and that's helped them score on the fast break.
New York trailing. And here's Richardson. Pass to Garnett. And here's Richardson. Six to shoot. Corner shot. And that one is right through the heart. Richardson's got 10 points here in the second half.
You know, he's doing whatever he wants on offense in this one.
Tipped away. Here we go. Here's Garnett. And he goes up strong with a one-handed jam.
And that's gotta hurt. A turnover for a free run at the rim.
And now we know who has the momentum.
Execution with pace, that's a bad turnover that simply was telegraphed.
Guarded by Richardson. Five to shoot. It's hauled in by Garnett. They're just trying to hold on to this lead, Grant.
And right now, you just can't afford to be careless. It's beginning to seem like they've gotten complacent defensively. They showed much more intensity in the first half.
Pass to Bird. The three ball. Boston, no good that time either.
Well, he was terrific in the first half, guys. Maybe some adjustments from the opposing team coach, and he's lost a little bit of that touch here in the second.
And he's going for the lob, and then Russell with the dunk.
And that was just moving the ball quickly, and he's rewarded at the end with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down, but when he gets room like that, you got to look out.
Darn it, that's good.
And you know Coach loves seeing his offense operate at this level. Great passing out there.
Pass to Cousy. Here's Cowens. Here's Havlicek. Let's go with a three. Knocks down the triple. He's got 21.
Shut out from beyond the arc in the first period. He finally drains one.
Outside Richardson. Elbow shot on the way. Ewing, no good.
That's gotta frustrate him. He knows he should have made that one.
Yeah, you can't make them all, and you for sure you'll want him taking that kind of shot.
I know he's on a cold streak, but he can't let that get in his head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts, but otherwise, the mindset is, I just gotta get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
While playing with the lead, they've been working for more high percentage shots they can depend on.
And a look at how the offensive approach has been going so far for the Knicks.
They feel like they have an advantage inside. And so far, they have done an excellent job exploiting it.
And they've also done a great job of just taking what the defense is giving them. Teams willing to give up a mid-range, take them, knock them down, they've done it.
Boston trailing. Pass to Bird. Right side, Russell. Here's Havlicek. Back to Russell. Good! Now 7 for 11 on the night.
Are we sure that's the same player, guys? He looks completely different. What confidence he's playing with, and look how engaged he is on both ends.
Now here's Richardson, guarded closely. Pass to Ewing. Nails the baby hook. And the Knicks lead by four.
And they're shooting with much more confidence here in the second half. The field goal percentage is now over 50%.
Here's Bird from deep three-point range. It's hauled in by Garnett.
It's been a struggle all night long from deep, but doesn't seem like he's lost his confidence. He's still letting them rip.
To the inside. Oh, a great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and a nasty jam.
Attacking the rim with power.
Tremendous finish. Boston on offense. Pass to Havlicek. Left side, Richardson. Ooh, good finish at the rack off the slick feed. And now an 8-point New York lead.
Just so successful getting the ball inside and finding those great looks.
Timeout called, the Celtics.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tide?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
Present our New Balance player of the game.
And I'll tell you what, this was one easy pick for sure. From the start, he looked in total control for the entire game. It's incredible to see a player outperforming everyone else on the court.
Boy, you can see the amazing relationship he's built with the hometown fans, and it motivates him to always give them his very best. All right, let's check in with Ali LaForce.
Hey guys, the head coach for the Celtics had some instruction for his guys during the break. He went after his players about their poor defense in the paint, saying, quote, "You're showing no fight down there. You're letting them get any shot they want, and they're feasting on us. Show some toughness and push back, guys."
Thanks for that, Allie. Bird. Second chance shot. The shot off that time. New York goes the other way with it. Here's Garnett. Pass to Richardson. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity.
Defensive foul charged to Bob Cousy. That's his first.
And the Celtics making a change here. Tatum's checked in.
Checking in for the Celtics, Jason Tatum. Michael Ray Richardson at the line. One shot.
Tatum with it. They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Got a piece of it. Here's Garnett.
2 minutes remaining.
Uses the glass to finish the layup. 32 points in the game for him.
Since half, there's been a stark contrast between these teams. I'm talking about efficiency at the offensive end.
Well, this team did something at halftime, going from a mild-mannered half-court executing team to some heroic shooting in the second half.
On the wing, Richardson. And it's good for two. Richardson's got seven now in this quarter.
They've been battling all night. Now they're on the brink of putting this game away.
Oh, great job of getting in position to win a game. It's been an all-out effort from the squad.
1:21 left in the fourth quarter. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
It's another just bad decision on a night full of those. His shot selection tonight has been questionable at best.
And Grant, as NBA players start to have more of a platform, we still hear those who say, shut up and dribble. What are your thoughts about this?
I think it's silly and it's unfortunate. And if you don't like it, then change the channel.
But players today, matter of fact, everybody today has a voice through their social media channels. And it just so happens that NBA players have large platforms that reach people all over the world.
Now, don't expect the players to be anything other than themselves. Knocks it down from distance. And the Knicks lead by 20.
Finishing the game strong. This is how you shut the door on any hopes of a comeback.
Well, yeah, definitely putting a stamp on this one. A very, very decisive victory for the club tonight.
Here's Garnett. Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
You can feel the excitement in this arena. These guys have done one heck of a job.
A huge motivation, always great for a young team, but veteran players also appreciate when fans come with that kind of energy and get into the spirit of the game.
A shot to stop the run. Oh, Tatum slams it home.
The speed of Tatum's drive makes it so tough to defend. You just don't get a chance to stop him.
And so it's the Knicks taking care of business in this one. They didn't have too many problems tonight.
They didn't. Just a tremendous team effort. Once they had that big lead, they were not going to let the visitors back into the game.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. So alongside Grant Hill, Ali LaForce, Brent Berry, and our entire 2K crew, I'm Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. So long and good night, everyone.
right in front of him. I just tapped his shoulder, so I know that he is touchable. In my